I'm Connor Hanlon from Miami.
Today I'm preparing a braised Australian lamb shank with a vadu-van curry. So first we're going to start off with our dry rub. Shanks are a pretty dense cut of meat. You know, I recommend letting them marinate for a couple hours. That flavor will come back out as we braise it. So next we're going to sear off the lamb shanks and get a nice caramelization on all sides. You want to get a really, really hot pan. I recommend using a cast iron pan or something that's very conducive to heat. I use Australian lamb because I think it has a great flavor. You know, the Australian lamb is it's a pasture-raised, grass-fed product. Next, we're gonna pull the lamb shanks out of the pan, saute our onions, shallots, garlic. We're gonna deglaze with some of the tomato paste and get a little toast on it. Finish off with our coconut milk and our chicken stock. So next, we have the vadu-van, which is kind of like what brings everything together for this dish. Vadu-van, again, is a French-influenced curry. Any curry really substitutes for this recipe. If you have Madras curry at your house, or if you want to try to substitute a Thai curry, place the lid on top of the shanks and put it in the oven for about 2 to 3 hours. So we took a trip to Australia. There's a group of us from the US that all went over, and it was very informative. We got to experience a lot of the meat and livestock of Australia, not just lamb, but beef as well, and see how they're raised, which to me, I think translates to the flavor of the food. We're just pulling this out of the oven. It's been cooking for about 3.5 hours. It should be nice and tender. Take the top off. Now this looks great. It's a great hearty dish for the winter time. As you can see, it's just falling off the bone tender. Some fresh lime juice just really, you know, wakens up the whole dish. Here we have our braised Australian lamb shank, seasoned with vadu-van curry, finished off with fresh lime juice and cilantro. I'm Connor Hanlon, and I cook with Aussie Lamb.